Let's get magical. Let's get magical automations. I'm sure some of you have seen videos I've put out on this channel before about automation tools like Zapier. And while Zapier is a great product, there are a lot of different things that it falls short of in comparison to a product like the one you'll see in this video, Magical. So before we get into the video talking about how Magical has some amazing features in the automation space, I will say this video is sponsored, but these opinions are my own. So first and foremost, what is Magical? Magical is a very cool tool that is essentially a AI powerhouse. It allows you to write with AI in a lot of different ways, and it's a very convenient Chrome extension. But not only that, it also allows you to automate tasks. It's a unique place between AI and automation, as there's no building required, and you can work, and Magical makes automations for you throughout the systems that you have. And a really great part about it is that it works on any website with no APIs needed to over 30,000 sites. So now that you know the different aspects of Magical and how it's different from Zapier regarding no build, automations, how it works on any site, and that there's no APIs needed, let's talk about those individually and what necessarily those automations look like. So first of all, when we're talking about no build automations, you don't have to learn a complex system and light coding to get time-saving automations at all. Instead of no code, you just do your work, typing, copying, pasting, and Magical will essentially build automations for you. These are essentially for data entry and for autofill automations. So these can be done on any website, and I'm sure a lot of you have experienced this when you're just working and you tend to do a lot of different things consistently, and you just would prefer that you didn't have to do it manually. This little guy right here, if you open up this on the side, you'll see this is the Magical experience, where there are some example automations that are already made here. So for example, click any text on the site. So say you have a scraping process for going through your LinkedIn feed and just kind of looking at different people that you could add to a Google sheet for a CRM, for example. So let me just scroll through and find a couple different people here that I think could be good potential clients for my business. So what you do at the start here is press on this button on the right, which is the Chrome extension. And then from there, you essentially add any of the different info you want from this page. So for example, I want to actually have how many followers they have too. So I can just type out like followers. Okay, cool. Press save. And then what about where they're from? So location. Awesome. Those are some things I want. So press continue to automation. And then what I can do next is very simply press add to a new spreadsheet. And you'll see there's an option to transfer all similar tabs. And I would say all tabs. Yeah, I want to grab all these similar tabs, all these LinkedIn. So if I click on all tabs here, you'll see that it'll get a huge number of tabs that I've set up in my browser. So I can press add to a new spreadsheet for all tabs. And then in a moment, you'll see that it'll get all of their data very quickly. Boom, look at that. It's absolutely crazy. What a large set of data that we got here. And we could spread this out to get more context for everybody. We can spread this data out as much as we want, like their headline and whatnot, if we want to just see it in the largest format. But all of their job title information, school names, company names, location, definitely spread that out. And you'll see that over 40 different contacts from LinkedIn were added into this. How awesome. Yeah. Imagine if I actually had to scrape all that data. No, that would not be fun. And this can be the case for individual ones as well. And it doesn't just work on LinkedIn. This can be the case in plenty of different websites or otherwise, whether it be Twitter or anything you can think of. Magical has 30,000 current integrations and counting. And it's really great for teams that have a homegrown app or database. Other competitors have a narrower list. And this is great for those tools you didn't think that you could connect. So this works not only on a tool like LinkedIn, it can work on homegrown tools as well. You can actually test this out if you'd like on anything else like we have here. If we try out this Magical automation, you'll see that really quickly, it allows you to add all of this data, map it so quick without having to do pretty much any work. I mean, I'm just here. This was added. This is why this product is so great in comparison to Zapier for tools you didn't think you could utilize automations with. I mean, just look at how quick that was able to add stuff. That's not something that I've ever experienced with a tool like Zapier for products that are, for example, this magical in-house form. Magical has 30,000 current integrations and counting. And it's really great for teams that have a homegrown app or database. Other competitors have a narrower list. And this is great for those tools you didn't think that you could connect. A really nice part about that process, as I'm sure you noticed, is that outside of just quickly giving that authentication to Google, you don't need to use APIs or worry about privacy. Like, this happens all on your browser and your machine specifically, so it can work where APIs are lacking, and it works in a secure way without PII passing to Magical. When it comes to other competitors like Zapier, they can't automate when there are no APIs. This is strictly happening in a way that doesn't involve that. So I'm going to show you now the process for form fillouts, which is another great thing. So if I type /, you'll notice right here that I have the ability to put in something like Dara McKay, who is in fact a client. And well, this may not be a company name. There are instances where I have clients where we just use their name in the system. And this is just grabbing data from an open tab, which is really convenient and easy to use. And that extra context from other pages is really great when I don't want to type out a name incorrectly and then the form wouldn't fill out accurately with the data. And as you can see, LinkedIn is a great platform to use in conjunction with Magical. So I definitely recommend you try to use the product with this form feature while having different LinkedIn tabs open. There's some really great ways that this can work. So for example, if you just want to fill out like all of your personal data, or other people's data that you have in other tabs that you want to just transfer over, like customer IDs and things like that, it's actually a much better process than copying and pasting. And I would like to find a way that Zapier can do that when you're just like naturally interacting with the browser. Guess what? You can't. That's really where that part about working in with any site and no APIs come into play. And the fact that I don't recall building anything at any point during this process at all. It's very simple. It's very quick and easy. All I needed to do was press a couple buttons and utilize this little section on the right here with pretty minimal effort. It's a great product, and I hope that you can give it a try today. With that being said, thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and check out more content like this one, and I'll improve your skills using tools like Magical today.